turn to the book of Proverbs. I'm going to start right there. And as the Spirit lead me, I'm going to let him have his way. Amen.
Amen.
Because he downloaded a good little bit. So I'm going to let him have his way. And then I'm going to get on out the way. Amen.
That's all right.
Glory to God. The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, 5 and 6, tells us, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Now, in order for us to be in servanthood,
amen,
and to serve, we must be able to trust God with all of our heart,
that's right,
all of our mind, and all of our soul.
Amen.
We cannot lean to our own understanding when we have been summoned and called to be a servant in the kingdom of God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. We cannot have a heart of a servant if we're not trusting in God with all our heart and trying to do things according to our own nature.
Amen.
Meaning our own way of understanding things. A servant of God has to be led by the Spirit of God.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the only way that we can serve and serve the way God wants us to be serve in the kingdom is being served by the Spirit of God.
That's right.
Which is the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Amen. He is the Spirit of truth. Right. Amen. He will lead us in the right direction.
Yes.
But first of all, we have to trust him in the Lord and then acknowledge him in all our ways.
Yes.
Not some of our ways, but all our ways.
Yes.
When I say all our ways, we serve a holistic God.
Yes.
A God that cares about everything that's concerning us.
Yes.
Husband, wife, children, mother, relationships, jobs, whatever it is.
Amen.
That he has blessed us with, that's what he cares about. He's a holistic God.
Yes.
So he wants us to acknowledge him.
Uh-huh.
But see, sometimes we are going by our day and we are miss and not acknowledge God about some of the things that go on in our life.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
But yet we still are servants of God.
Yeah.
All right. When we try to do things according to our own nature, things become very complicated.
Uh-huh.
They become frustrating.
Uh-huh.
We get very aggravated.
Jesus.
We become restless and can't sleep. We toss and turn.
Yeah.
We ain't got no peace in our spirit.
Jesus.
We become anxious. And he said, let us not be anxious about anything.
Amen.
But let our request be made known unto God by prayer and supplication.
Yes.
That's why he wants us to acknowledge him.
Yep.
But when we don't acknowledge him, and when we try to serve and do things according to our own nature,
yes, sir,
we wonder why. This is complicated.
Amen.
I can't think straight. I don't know which way to turn. I don't know which way to go. Because we're not acknowledging God. See, when we begin to trust him in all our ways and acknowledge him in every part of our life, he will then make our pathway straight.
Yes.
As a servant in his kingdom.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Help me, Holy Ghost.
Jesus.
God, I thank you. Trust. But when we learn how to trust and serve God with our whole heart and acknowledge him in everything in our servanthood, then he'll make the pathway of servanthood straight.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I want to reassure you tonight that servanthood is an issue of the heart.
All right. Amen. Now, all right.
I'm going to repeat that if that's all right.
That's all right.
Servanthood is an issue of the heart.
Of the heart.
Servanthood starts with the heart of a man.
Uh-huh.
The heart of a man is the innermost being of a man.
Yeah.
That's the depth of your soul.
Yeah.
That's where Christ lives.
Yeah.
Inside our heart.
That's right, Evangelist.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
In my years of coming up, I always heard people say, follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
They would always tell you if I come to them with a decision and something that's going on, people that told me, my family members, follow your heart.
Jesus.
Well, I come to believe that to be true.
Uh-huh.
Because the Bible said, for where your treasure is,
that
where your heart will be also.
Uh-huh.
Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Meaning, our hearts should follow after what is our treasure.
Yes.
Now, what you treasure the most, that's what your heart will follow.
Amen.
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 In servanthood, somebody say, we talking about servanthood tonight.
Servanthood.
Your treasure should be Jesus.
Amen. Jesus.
In servanthood and a servant in the kingdom of God, your treasure should be Jesus.
Should be Jesus.
And that is who our heart should be following behind.
Preach it, daughter.
If you're following behind anything else than Jesus, then that's not, then that's what you are serving. Amen. And that is where your heart is.
That's right.
That's the word of God.
The word.
Oh, glory to God.
Say it, daughter.
Amen.
Jesus is our treasure.
Uh-huh.
And our heart in servanthood has to follow Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. See, our heart determines the course of our life.
Amen.
It also determines how we serve God.
Uh-huh.
It also determines how we serve our leaders.
Uh-huh.
Come on, here, somebody.
Amen.
It also determines how we serve one another in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Right. Glory to God.
Jesus.
It also determines how we serve the whole body of Christ.
Yes.
Along with the task that God has given us to do while we're here in this earth realm. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God. Now, somebody say, well, how do you know, Evangelist? I'm going to tell you what the word says.
Amen.
The word of the Lord told us. That's why I say it's a heart issue.
Uh-huh.
Guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Another translation says in NIV, above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from your heart.
That's right.
Everything we do flows from your heart.
From your heart.
The word of the Lord also said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
That's right.
So that shows when you speak, it shows what's inside of your heart.
Yes.
So we got to be careful what we speak.
That's
we
right.
Speak
that's
as
right.
Servants in the kingdom of God.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
So as a servant of God, our heart desires, catch this, heart desire. We must have a heart desire.
Fire.
When you got a desire for nothing, something, nothing will get in your way.
Nothing.
When you desire something bad enough, there is no kind of excuse to stop you from getting to where your heart is desiring to get to.
Yes.
I don't care what come in the way. I don't care what you feel like.
Yes.
I don't care what else going on. You make no excuses because your heart is, has a desire
yes,
to
sir.
Get to what should always be, our heart desires as servants,
yes,
shall always be one thing, please God.
Please God. Please
Him. Amen.
Please God.
Yes, sir.
Whatever He has given us to do in the ministry, let it be pleasing unto God.
Amen.